game. Speech all flame. Street y'all blame. It should be an honor for y'all to speak my name.
Hey, how you talk that pop shit when you roll with Ben? Hey! I thought you blew trees with him, push bees with him. Couldn't wait to go on tour across the
nation. Because we came from Philadelphia. You know what I mean? You got people, I mean, I was from South Filthy. You got people from Young Chris and them from the North of Death. And it go down.
The battle with you and Jadakiss.
Yeah.
Went down as one of the great battles.
Yeah.
Talk about that. I mean, was it personal with you and Jada, or was it really just some hip hop shit?
Nah, it wasn't. I believe at that time Jada was on a couple records that was Jay clipped them off of.
Lifting the skirt, ripping your earth, blowing weed, no Corona Deluxe. Phony, wanna roll in the truck, but they don't know what was up. You messing with squillers, I'm messing with killers. I'm the prince of the hood, I'm the one who wrote the criminal pillars. You can holla at me, I'm the one with the money.
When it comes to hip-hop beefs, there comes a time when certain rappers like to take the streets and replace it with battling on wax, and it always presents itself with tragic occurrences. I've definitely seen this happen with a lot of today's hip-hop beefs and whatnot. You know, you have motherfuckers thinking that they're from the streets and shit like that. It's like, whatever happened to the battles on wax? You know what I'm saying? Whatever happened to rappers just dissing each other on wax or just battling on stage? Whatever happened to that? You know, now these days every beef you hear is always like some violent occurrence or whatever. Now enter Jadakiss and Beanie Sigel, two of the greatest MCs at their prime, in my opinion. Jadakiss being from the Locks, you know, originally with Bad Boy Records, and Beanie Sigel, you know, down with Roc-A-fella, State Property, and whatever. Excuse me. Both of those rappers had one of the best beefs, in my opinion. And mind you, this also happened in 2001. Like, 2001 definitely brought a lot of good beefs in hip hop, like Jay-Z and Nas, and then the Nas and Queensbridge, and so on and so on. But yeah, we're definitely going to talk about this beef, though, the Beanie Sigel and Jadakiss beef. Let's start this in 1998. You know, Jay-Z, he was pretty much looking for talent in Philadelphia, and that's when he came across this young Philly MC by the name of Beanie Sigel. And so, you know, he got, you know, acquired with his sound and style, and that's when he brought him to rap on his third studio album, Volume 2, Hard Knock Life. Now, Volume 2, Hard Knock Life was released on September 29th, 1998, on Roc-A-fella under Def Jam Records. It was known for the singles Can I Get a, Hard Knock Life Ghetto Anthem, Money Cash Hoes, and Nigga What, Nigga Who. In chart-wise, commercially, this is Jay-Z's most successful album, peaking at number one on the Billboard 200 and the R&B hip-hop albums charts. When I first heard this album, I'm not going to lie, it was not really one of my favorites from Jay-Z, because me personally, it was like a lot of collabs compared to like the first two albums. But now over years, I've came to appreciate this album. Dare I even say it's a classic album? You know, this one was really the album that we know Jay-Z for this day and age. You know what I'm saying? And so the song that Jay-Z and Beanie collaborated on, and ironically also featured the Locks and Sauce Money, was Reservoir Dogs. Now fast forward to 1998, you know, Jay-Z, you know, he still wanted to assembly a lot of Philly MCs. And so he got up with this another Philly collective by the name of Major Figures. And, you know, Major Figures was also known because it also featured Gilly the Kid. And you guys should know who Gilly the Kid is because of the fact that, you know, he had that beef with Lil Wayne back in the 2000s. And so things kind of turned sour because the major figures pretty much, you know, they felt some kind of way when, you know, they were all the attention on Beanie Sigel. And so when Beanie Sigel wanted to get the figure signed to Roc-A-fella, you know, Jay-Z quote unquote tried to lowball them, and that's when the beef on Wax happened. And, you know, Jay-Z also threw some subliminal shots on the 1999 song Do It Again off the Volume 3 Hard Knock, Volume 3 The Life and Times of S. Carter and whatnot. So yeah, man, that's very interesting. But, you know, when it comes to, like, Beanie Sigel, he was pretty much, like, the main MC, like, that bridged the gap between, like, the Philly hip-hop and the New York hip-hop when it came to Roc-A-fella. Now, enter Jadakiss. Now, Jadakiss, you know, he originally started off, you know, with Bad Boy Records, you know, when he was on Lox and whatnot, you know, rhyming with Biggie. You know, I think their first appearance, the breakthrough was the song You'll See, featuring Biggie, which is a very, very dope song. That was like on, you know, some mixtape. And then now Money, Power, Respect was the debut album from the Lox that was released on January 13th, 1998 on Bad Boy Records. This is known for singles such as If You Think I'm Jiggy and Money, Power, Respect. You know, the album was very successful. It peaked at number 3 on the Billboard 200 and number 1 on the R&B Hip Hop Albums charts. Personally, this is not really one of my favorite albums from the Lox, but at the same time, I don't really dislike it. I kind of prefer the We Are the Streets album, but I feel like it's a very enjoyable listen, you know what I'm saying? Gun, no flip book, keep hunger and plan for the future, cause you figure you're gonna be older, way longer than you're gonna be younger. Need life, 1 pound respect, but you need life, 1 pound respect, but you need right. So, you know, despite the success of Money, Power, Respect, they were having some issues with Puffy due to contract and money. So this led them, you know, to relocate to Rough Riders Records, you know what I'm saying? And this is where I personally feel like the Lox found their sound or whatnot, you know what I'm saying? Or D-Block, as I should say.
So, three kids from Yonkers getting a shot. Who really, really want this thing very, very bad.
When you do listen to the tape, how long from the time you put the tape in can you tell if this is something you're interested in?
10 seconds.
We're gonna get this started. You all got to do. We're gonna get this started right now. Have a seat, have a seat, have a seat. What's good? Everything, everything. Now, for those people who may not know, are not familiar with the Lox and Double R and how y'all came up, go back to the beginning. What was it like coming up as the Lox, and how has things changed from then to now?
I mean, we always just kept it in the hood, you know? From the bottom up is our whole, that's our whole style, like, you know? Hope for the best, expect the worst. Make use of whatever we got, and then, you know, that's how we introduced it to the world.
No doubt. I mean, if I can comment on that, you know what I'm saying? You know, I knew this brother, you know what I'm saying, most of his life, you know what I'm saying? He knew me most of my life, you know what I'm saying? It's a wild thing. Lox been the Lox, and ain't nothing changed.
And, you know, Beanie Sigel and Jadakiss, they were already, you know, getting familiar with one another and stuff like that because their crews pretty much cross each other's paths here and there. Like I said, on songs like Reservoir Dogs, and I know that Beanie and I, you know, appeared on the Foxy Brown song, the 456 joint. Now, once Jadakiss had his solo career with guest appearances and whatnot, he became a force to be reckoned with when it came to East Coast hip-hop. And so, you know, with, you know, the Rough Riders behind his back and whatnot too, you know, Jadakiss, you know, he would definitely face a lot of competition. There's a couple of theories on to why this beef started, but I'm going to point to about a couple of factors. In my opinion, one of the factors include in a 2001 issue of The Source magazine, you know, Jadakiss did an interview where he was talking about how, you know, the impact that Philly rappers had. And some believe that Jadakiss claimed that rappers from Philadelphia were biting his style and flow and whatnot too. And so others took it as like that it grew from a natural rivalry that was developing between Roc-A-fella and Rough Riders for the New York rap supremacy. And he's crazy too because, you know, both Rough Riders and Roc-A-fella Records were like headed by DMX and Jay-Z respectively. And both of those MCs had a very, you know, complicated love-hate relationship over the years and whatnot, which I'm definitely going to talk more about that when I talk about, you know, the Murder, Inc. supergroup and whatnot. So stay tuned on that, because that's going to be a very dope episode. And speaking of Jay-Z, believe it or not, he's like one of the reasons why this beef between Beanie and Jadakiss started. Now, fast forward to 2000. R&B pop singer Maya, you know, she was, you know, blowing up, and she had a single called Best of Me. Best of Me was a single coming from her second album, Fear of Flying, that dropped on April 25th, 2000 on University Music Entertainment, which was under Interscope Records. This was known for songs such as Best of Me, Case of the X, and Free. Commercially, it was very successful and whatnot. You know, it debuted at number 15 on the Billboard 200. You know, it definitely was very successful. And I know they recently released the album too. But back to the main thing I was trying to talk about was.
I got so many bags of money that they won't fit in the bank. And I'ma do this just like Tony did it to Frank. But I'ma make sure both y'all win. Let them keep the place. You move and I'ma pay both y'all rent.
Was the fact that the original version of Best of Me had Jadakiss on a single. And you know, that definitely was a huge single at that time too. But then everybody knows the Best of Me Part 2 that Jay-Z was featured on and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? And that was a way bigger impact than the first one, you know?
Nigga mad when I brag about the cash I got, but I'm used to not having a lot. I'm from the gutter and I ain't the type to ever chase your box. I'm the type to interior decorate the watch. I'm the type to sling heavyweight on the block in every state like clock, work jiggers.
Okay, so all of this sounds innocent, right? Well, pretty much fast forward 1 year later, this time it was R. Kelly. R. Kelly had a song called Fiesta. And Fiesta, you know, that was from the TP2.com album, which again, that was another successful album between 2000, one of R. Kelly's best albums in my opinion. And so the next year, Jay-Z and R. Kelly did the Jay-Z and R. Kelly did the Fiesta Part 2, which everybody knows about that joint right there. Everybody was bumping that, you know what I'm saying? That was known for, you know, the video and stuff like that too. So
Billy behind the face, Rockland sitting on Capitol Hill, Trackmaster make capital deals.
Now look, you got the iced out with the blingy bling and a big body sitting on them gleamy things. Now Rockland niggas know the means of cream. Kellyanne be thug and it seems the king. Got PJ niggas in Cabrini green, hot chicks down to do anything.
Fiesta remix with the homie from the Midwest side. Game recognized, game new too. It's a new two live crew. I suppose you're new, so thugs, but don't approach us or to chase you like.
Yes, sir. So now Jadakiss and the Rough Riders camp, they didn't really take it too kindly and whatnot, and so pretty much, you know, they were saying that this nigga's always jumping on remixes. This nigga's always trying to one up me and whatnot. And, you know, at that time, too, Jay-Z was dealing with Nas and beefing with Nas. So he felt like, you know, he didn't want to go after Rough Riders. So, you know, he pretty much got Beanie Sigel. You know, he told him to just give all his attention to the Rough Riders and crew and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? So now we're going to get into the year 2001. Beanie Sigel dropped his second album, The Reason, under Roc-A-fella and Def Jam. Album was a commercial success, debuted at number 5 on the Billboard 200. It was known for two singles, Beanie Mac Bitch and Think It's a Game. And the song Beanie Mac Bitch is interesting because many thought that he was taking a subliminal at Jadakiss with the line, and I quote, "I sit 430 deep in wheels, you about 430 cheap in wheels. Look at your small rim, small wheel, small grill, beat beans, sitting in the Bentley, my heart peels."
When I skate past the shit, I sit 430 deep in wheels, you about 430 cheap in wheels, small bins, look at your small rim, small wheel, small grill, big beans, sit in the Bentley, my heart peel. 0 to 60 so quickly, how you want it, you can have it, drop top stick shit.
And at that time, you know, that Mercedes was like a very popular and expensive car at that time, and he's making fun of his rival, you know, for his model right quick, you know what I'm saying? So that's one thing people got from that line. Months later, Jadakiss dropped his album Kiss the Game Goodbye on August 7, 2001. This album ironically debuted at number 5 as well, and number 2 on the R&B and Hip Hop Albums chart. Probably Jadakiss's best album, in my opinion, known for songs like We Gonna Make It, Knock Yourself Out, but was also known for this one track called Uh-Huh with DMX, where this time Jadakiss was not really putting Beanie's name out here on wax, while DMX, on the other hand, was throwing shots at Jay-Z. And this track was definitely a banger, you know, definitely had some lines in him that Beanie like, shoot to kill, stomp niggas out, bout to grill, I'll give you a reason why I'm the truth for real, Nas can't fuck with the Kiss, I mean that, like, just an ill ass track right there. And now the beef was definitely on full display.
Oh, catch a chicken, fucking with me, you gone, catch a whipping.
Uh-huh, here we go again. Uh-huh, here we go again. Uh-huh, here we go again. Uh-huh, here we go again.
Uh-huh,
here we go again.
Uh-huh,
here we go again.
Uh-huh,
here we go again.
Uh-huh,
here we go.
So Beanie didn't waste no time. He jumped on the DJ Envy mixtape, The Empire Strikes Black. And what he did was, he took Jadakiss's Put Your Hands Up beat. Not only that, imitated the intro to the song Blood Pressure. And fucking savage Jadakiss, in my opinion. Possibly my favorite diss track off this whole battle, in my opinion. Because this was definitely where shit definitely escalated. You know what I'm saying?
My blood pressure is building. The headphones is on fire this time around. Bleak, about to squeeze this shoe.
Oh, Billy!
Billy!
Oh,
yeah, fuck the speculation, talk over. Nigga, dig this. I'm about to sun kiss like a soda and make J to the moi. Put his lips on his nine and really kiss the game goodbye. You about to really make me hurt you, kiss. Spitting candy bars. This nigga sweeter than a.
Jadakiss responded with a freestyle over this pop beat and whatnot, and he kind of kept this one short, but still has some lines aimed at Beanie Sigel. My opinion, definitely another dope diss track where Jadakiss really shines lyrically.
We got all kind of work. You beat niggas the fuck up. See me when you see me. I don't want to have me. Yo, fuck you.
Yeah, when I met you, you was on my dick. Jigga gave you his old Bentleys. Now you want some shit. I don't know where they found you, son. But since your pops ain't around, I'ma punish you and ground you, son. And niggas can't stand you, Sigel. Your flow is mine anyway, so don't bite the hand that feeds you. Them niggas.
So now we're gonna get into October of 2001. Jadakiss performed at Powerhouse, which was located in Philly, the home place of Beanie Sigel. And you know, Powerhouse was like this big annual concert and whatnot, you know, and Jadakiss did his thing on set, and after he performed We Gonna Make It, he cut it off and he spit an acapella freestyle basically dissing Beanie in his hometown and shit like that. And the crowd, you know, they didn't react that well, you know what I'm saying? They started booing him. But Jadakiss, he really did not really take anything. He didn't really take anything to heart, because what happened was he just said he had love for Philly and whatnot, and you know, it was all for competition. However, and this is the interesting thing, Puffy was at that concert too, and somehow, some way, he got in contact with Beanie Sigel, and Beanie Sigel arrived there and pretty much dropped another a cappella freestyle. And it's kind of funny because, you know, at that time, Puffy and Lox was beefing too, so it's definitely kind of funny how he played a part in this.
Boy, hold up, Roc, I gotta do my shit. You know, it's a lot of talk, everybody saying this
let
and that.
Motherfucking know,
but
dog.
You know,
yeah.
Check it out. I give all of y'all a few in the dome. So when you see me, think about a funeral home. A lot of niggas get fed to the crabs. And yeah, I'm a boss. Four hoes give me head in a bath. Pound of weed is like a medicine bag. I look at my son different. Gun spitting, head in your back. Stand over the body, fire again. Send Siegel a wire, I'm riding again. We get
it. How you talk that pop shit when you roll with Ben? Hey! I thought you blew trees with him, push bees with him. Couldn't wait to go on tour and cross me. Whoa, whoa. Jason. I do this like I do it for Friend. BET or MTV, we can call Don King. Get it done, my dog, on PPV. Pay per view, nigga, bring a gauge of two. Let's have a steel gauge, man. So steel cage.
Yeah, this incident regarded as one of the most iconic moments when it comes to battling hip-hop, in my opinion. Like, and the thing about this is, was it wasn't until a while later that, and this is coming from both of them, that they met at a charity event, and they pretty much decided to keep it going for the sport as long as they keep it on wax, you know what I'm saying? So now we get into 2002, and this is really much around the time when both Beanie and Jadakiss were actually going after each other on mixtapes and freestyles. And what was also crucial was the fact that both of the crews, State Property and Lox, were also getting into it as well too. Now, State Property actually appeared on an episode of Rap City in 2002, you know, promoting their project, promoting their movie, and they took into the Rap City booth where they diss D-Block, you know what I'm saying?
They can't stick to the script, I'ma give him a clip. Styles die on a holiday,
right.
Kids die on a holiday. Shots like first of the year,
uh-huh.
On your block like first of the month. You get shot from the front to the rear. Got Glocks in the back of the trunk. Got pumps on the back of the seat.
For all y'all, Matt cooked this beef. That lost kiss took speaks for all y'all. Man, they all bras. I got something fresh out the box. Instead to tempt me, I let them all
so the Lox pretty much were taking over the mixtapes with freestyles. And they freestyled over Jay-Z beats. And what was interesting was the fact that they were dissing Jay, Beanie, the whole Roc-A-fella. Like they did a freestyle over to Somebody's Girl track from the Jay-Z and R. Kelly album, The Best of Both Worlds. And they also did one on Jigga That Nigga from Jay's The Blueprint album. And so this was all appearing on DJ Clues Presents Desert Storm Volume 3, Grand Theft Audio 2.
Oh, stupid nigga, I rob you blind. Let a nigga talk too much, his ass is mine. Stomach a pop, lungs a drop. Fingers a break, call what cop? And I ain't one to talk, my mouth is full. I'm eating your food, I'm using your fork.
No doubt.
Cause after tonight, won't floss that shit around me. Nah, not around me. Stick a kid for real, nigga, talk to stale. I'm real, got nothing to hide. I got a trench coat with jewelry.
I want to say that Styles P definitely did his thing on a lot of these tracks, man. Like, he definitely has some ill lines, like, we can have a knife fight, tell me what your life like, my answer's real, everything signed and sealed, what I spit is so real, they better put it in pills, and stuff like that, which he was referencing the Beanie Sigel track, What Your Life Like, and they were all those throwing shots at Freeway too. And at that time, Freeway was just starting out at that time. I want to say his debut album didn't really come out until 2003. So yeah, man. So he was already making a name for himself at that time. And at that time, Jay-Z and Nas were still beefing. So State Property and Lox was still going ham. And pretty much what happened was State Property appeared on Funk Master Flex's Hot 97. Everybody except Petey Crack, by the way. And so they did a freestyle and whatnot, you know, they were dissing Lox and Nas. And what was also interesting was the fact that Flex and Beans were interviewing one another, and Beans says something like how he believes that battles are good as long as they stay on record and whatnot. And so this is what led to Funkmaster Flex playing the special delivery from G-Dep, and Sigel was just spitting darts, like dissing everybody, like he was just dissing Jada, he was dissing Styles and whatnot. He was also throwing some shots at Nas too, you know, with the line, "Let's take a journey through your life and shit," because that was also the song that Puffy and Nas did on the Forever album. It wasn't until his crew happened and stuff like that, and they were pretty much just saying, "Y'all don't want to fuck with us and whatnot, we the best crew."
Nasir Jones, Plato Nick. What I look like, Fredo nigga? See through you like glass. Trying to kill four birds with one stone by breaking a rock in half. Do the math, you get it later. I do your ass, probably get it later. I don't look that far in the future. I dwell on the present and past. I handle drama when it come to my path.
I'm like a Simon on the president ass.
You illmatic, got the medicine bag. And I'm the doctor, make the house visit. Form a 44D with the hollows in it. You got a banger from across in the cross position.
Yeah.
Chump, listen, don't you know I'm gutter?
One style, about to focus on Nas, you know?
Nasir Jones, Plato Nick. What I look like, a Fredo nigga? See through you like glass. Trying to kill four birds with one stone
by breaking a rock in half.
Do the math, you get it later. I do your ass, probably get it later. I don't look that far in the future. I dwell on the present and past. I handle drama when it come to my path.
I'm like a Simon on the president ass.
You illmatic, got the medicine.
Eventually, by the mid to late 2000s, the battle pretty much fizzled out. And both Beanie and Jada pretty much, you know, called the beef a quit. And what happened was that they collaborated on DJ Khaled's first album, Listen the Album, which was released on June 6, 2006 on Terror Squad under Scott Records.
Big four creep nigga, and when I go to war, I don't get shot, I just shoot niggas. And I don't trust a nigga far as I can throw him, even though I'm feeling strong enough for probably the roof niggas. Yeah, your boy back in the booth, nigga. I'm off the weed, but I'm back on my juice, nigga. I beat the case, so it's off with the.
Not only that, they also appeared on Fabulous, The Game, and the other two members of the Lox to do a remix on Chic Lucha's Kiss Your Ass Goodbye. And to sum it up, they both appeared on L. Joel's The Life We Live. In 2009, both Jadakiss and Beanie Sigel both performed live at the Powerhouse concert. This battle pretty much taught rappers that beef can stay on wax and we can have a competitive rivalry without actually going for the personal thoughts. You know what I'm saying? In the early 2000s, man, there were just a lot of beefs that was really happening that was just like, niggas was just going for the juggler, from Jay-Z to Nas to Eminem and Benzino. So I felt like this beef pretty much is like one of the last great hip-hop beefs on wax. Thank you so much for watching this episode, and stay tuned for more on Why the Beef.